in the distributed system models, we have three types. One is physical model, architectural model, and fundamental models. Okay. Coming to the physical model, this is the first model. The representation of underlying the hardware elements of a distributed system that abstracts away specific deals of the computer networking technologies. Okay, here, see, before going to discuss about a physical model, this is the very baseline model. Okay, this is the very baseline model. Baseline model means very, let's take a glance of a distributed system definition. Anywhere, from any place, we can connect with other nodes with cooperation. Coming to this physical model, this is the very base model. Very limited number of nodes are involved in the distributed system. And let's see an example of the different generations of distribution systems, how they will be. First, early 70s and 80s, the distribution systems is LAN-based systems. Only they are LAN-based systems. And the number is 10 to 100 nodes. The maximum number of nodes is 100. Okay. Next, after early 90s to 2010, the distributed system is like clusters. You know about cluster. Okay. Day before yesterday, I told you about cluster. Group of similar nodes is called as clusters, grids, P2P. Okay, these are involved in later models in early 90s to 2010. Now we are using contemporary distributed systems. In the contemporary distribution system, we are using dynamic nodes like mobile nodes. Mobile system means from anywhere we can carry that system from any. Previously, that is LAN-based system. That is nothing but fixed system. Now, in the contemporary distributed system, we are using dynamic nodes. That is, we are using mobile systems. All these mobile systems are having mobile location awareness services. And we are using clouds and we are using internet IoT. And everything. Okay, these three are three generations of distributed systems. Okay, the physical model is the base model, and very small number of nodes are involved in this model. Next model is architectural model. In the architectural model, see, an architectural model of a distributed system is concerned with the placement of its parts and relationship between them. Placement of its parts means parts is nothing but nodes. How the nodes are distributed. Okay, here this architectural model is concerned with placement of nodes and the relationship between them. Let's take an example of client server system and peer process models. See, in the client server can be modified by, see in the screen, the client server can be modified by the partitioning of data or the replication of data at operative servers. Okay, in the client server model, the partitioning of data and the replication is the thing to do. Same copy of data, duplication of data at cooperative servers. Okay. The caching of data by proxy servers or clients. You know about caching. The caching of data by proxy servers or clients. Okay. Normally, whenever we need data, we need to approach the server. All the time, we do no need to go for the servers. We need to cache the data at the clients and cache the data at the proxy servers. Okay, first we will go to the cache. If the data found in the cache, there is no problem. If the data not found in the cache, we go to the server. Next, the use of mobile code and mobile agents. Next, this is the architectural model. The main aim of the architectural model, the main concern of architectural model is the placement of parts, but the placement of the nodes and the relationship among the nodes. The example for this is client-server model and peer process models. Third model of distributed system is fundamental models. Okay, these fundamental models are mainly concerned with the formal description and properties that are common in all architectural nodes. These fundamental model mainly addressing synchronization, message delays, failures, security issues. Okay, these fundamental models mainly concentrates on time synchronization, message delay, failures, and security. On these four parameters, this fundamental model is concerned with. First, see the interaction model. Okay, interaction model in the fundamental model. In the interaction model, it deals with the performance and the difficulty of setting of time limits in a distributed system. Let's take an example. In the interaction model, let's take an example of a distributed system where all nodes are located at different places. In this, our concern is the difficulty of setting the time limits. Time limits means to transfer the data, to pass the message, there is a time limit. Okay, this is the challenge. Next one, failure model. Here, this failure model deals with the faults that can be exhibited by processes. Some processes may fail to deliver in the time. Some process may deliver the data. Some process may fails to pass the message. Okay, it will deals. It all those all comes under the failure models. Next one is security model. Okay, the security model discusses the possible threats to the processes and communication channels. Okay, the major three models in the distributed systems are: first one is the physical model. It is a base model and deals with very limited number of nodes. The next one, architectural model, is the main concern of this model is the placement of parts and the relationship between the parts. And the fundamental model mainly deals and addresses with four factors. The one is time synchronization, that is related to interaction model, message delays, that is related to failure model, and security issues, that is related to security model. Okay, next. Now we are going to discuss about the architectural models. Now we are going to discuss about the architectural models and how they will be. See, in the architectural models, we are going to discuss about, in the architectural model, we need to discuss about software layers, the system architecture. The system architecture means, in the system architecture, we are going to discuss about the client server. And in the client server model, we are discussing with one client and one server and clients and a single server, and clients with multiple servers, and clients with proxy servers, and clients with caches and peer model. Okay, all we know about one client, several clients are managed by one server. If the number of clients are increased, the server cannot accommodate all the clients. So in those cases, we may maintain different servers. In the client server model, clients and a single server, with multiple servers, with proxy servers, with caches, with peer models. We will discuss about these points. Next, the alternative client server models are driven by mobile node, mobile code, mobile agents, network computers, thin clients, mobile devices, and spontaneous networking. Next one, design challenges and requirements. These are the topics that we are going to discuss in architectural models. Okay. Coming to the architectural model, the architecture of a system is its structure in terms of separately specified components. See the point. The architecture of a system, your system is nothing but a distributed system. The architecture of your distributed system is its structure in terms of separately specified components. Okay. See, the goal is to meet the present and likely future demands. The major concerns are making the system reliable, manageable, adaptable, and cost effective. See, in the previous slide we have discussed about architectural model. In the architectural model, what I told you, the placement of its parts and relationship between them. That is the same here. Here, the main goal is to meet the present and likely future demands. The major concerns are making the system reliable, manageable, adaptable, and cost effective. Okay. And for the architectural model, it simplifies and abstracts the functions of individual components and the placement of components across the network of computers. See, the distribution system means all systems are, what is the definition of distributed system? All systems are autonomous systems. All systems are standalone computers, independent computers. So the placement of components across the network of computers is like define the patterns for distribution of data and workloads. Okay, we might assign the workload in the distribution system. The interrelationship between the components, that is the functional roles and the patterns of communication between them. Here, in the distribution system, every system works autonomously, every system works independently. So the interrelationship between the components, that is some system is assigned some functional role and other system might assign with another functional role. The interrelationship between these components and communication is very, very important. Why? Because all systems are, here there is no shared memory. This is the very important point you must note down. There is no shared memory in the distribution system. Every system works autonomously. See, the architectural model, an initial specific simplification of is achieved by classifying the processes. Here the processes are divided as server processes and client processes and peer processes. Here we know about server, we know about client. See, what is peer process? It's cooperate and communicate in a semantic manner. It cooperates and communicates in a symmetric manner to perform a task. Okay. See, the first diagram represents client-server processes, client and server. Then what is peer? Peer means these two. See my cursor point. These two are peer-to-peer systems. These peer-to-peer processes communicate in a symmetric manner to perform a task. Instead of contacting client to server and client server to client, this is one more process that is called as peer processes. Okay. Here in architectural model, processes are divided as three categories. One is server processes. Next one is client process. Third one is peer processes. Next, the software architecture. This part deals with software architecture and its layers. Okay. Here, see the diagram first. Layer 1, layer 2, layer n. Like OSI, you know, in computer networks, ISO OSI reference model, every below layer will provide services to its above layer. See here, layer 1 provides services to layer 2, layer 2 provides us to layer 3, and so on. Layer n minus 1 provides services to layer n. That is what mentioned here. Services offered to above layer. One offered to 2, 2 offered to 3, n minus 1 offered to n. Here, what is a layer? A group of related functional components are a layer. A group of related functional components is a layer. Then what is the services? The functionality provided to the next layer. See, this is the layer 1. What is this layer? A group of related components is a layer. Then what is the services it provides to above one? The functionality provided to the next layer. The functionality. Okay. See what they mentioned here. Breaking up the complexity of the systems by designing them through layers and services. Okay, these are the layered architecture. This is the software and hardware. Service layers in the distributed systems. In the distributed system, see, computer and network hardware is here. Next one is operating system. These two together called as platform. Next one is middleware, and at top one is applications and services. Application and services. What is middleware? Any one of you know? We know about operating system, we know about computer and network, we know about applications and services. Then what is the middleware? The middleware, it is a software that acts as a bridge between operating system and database. Yes, note it down. Middleware is a software that acts as bridge between an operating system or database and application. It operating system key, application key, sorry. It works as a bridge between operating system and applications, or operating system and database. Okay. This is how layers are in distributed system. In the first one, computer and network hardware and operating system. These two are together called as a platform. And here is the middleware software, which is a bridge between operating system and applications. Next, what is a platform? What I told you, what is a platform? The operating system and computer and network hardware together called as a platform. Now, what is a platform? The lowest hardware and software layers. Lowest hardware and software layers are often referred to as platform for distributed system and applications. Okay. The lowest one, computer hardware and software layers are often referred as platform for distributed systems and applications. These low level layers provide services to the layers above them. As I told you, these will provide services to above layers, okay, which are implemented independently in each computer. Okay, these are independently in each computer. The examples are some Intel x86, Windows x86, Linux, Intel x86, Solaris, PowerPC, Mac operating system, iPhone, iOS operating system, Android operating system, etc. Okay. Next, middleware. Okay, we discussed about these two. Next one is middleware. As I told you, a layer Middleware is the layer of software whose purpose is to mask the heterogeneity present in distributed systems and to provide a convenient programming model to application developers. Okay. The normal purpose of the middleware is, this is a software. Middleware is a software which acts as the bridge between the database and operating system, or it is a bridge between operating system and applications. Here, what they mentioned, a layer of software, that is middleware, whose purpose is to mask heterogeneity. Mask heterogeneity present in the distributed systems and to provide convenient programming model to application developers. Let's see. Mask heterogeneity. Here, the middleware must identify the heterogeneity. If there is a homogeneous, there is no problem. All systems are, as I told you, the properties of distributed systems, the principles of distributed system, heterogeneity. Heterogeneity means different kind of systems. They might use different operating systems. Okay. The purpose of this middleware software is to mask the heterogeneity present in the distributed systems. How many heterogeneous systems are in the distributed systems? It must identify, it must mask the heterogeneity and provide the convenient programming model to the application developers. Here, the application developers might use different languages to develop applications. Some might use Java, some might use .NET, some might use etc., etc. Okay, what it will provide, a convenient programming model to the application developers. Here, the major examples mentioned here are Sun RPS, that is remote procedural calls, and OMG Cobra. Cobra means, you know about Common Object Request Broker Architecture. Common Object Request Broker Architecture. This is called as CORBA. These are the major examples. See here, diagram. Here in this diagram, we have different web servers. Here we have RMI client, RMI server, web server, and RMI registry. Okay. Here, what RMI server, see how it works. Here, RMI client, how it will reaches to, how it will access the web server. See the procedure. Here, it will send the request to the RMI server. Here, RMI server will send the RMI request to the RMI registry. Here, the RMI registry will send the URL protocol to the web server. Or it might directly, RMI client directly uses the URL protocol to the web server. Okay. These are the major examples of middleware. Next, system architecture. Here, in this, coming to the system architecture for distributed system, is the division. Is the division of responsibilities between the system components. Here, the major part is the division of responsibilities between the system components. What are the system components? Applications, servers, clients, etc. Okay, the division of responsibilities between the system components and the placement of components on computers in the network. First, first responsibility is distribution of division of responsibilities. Next, placement of components on computers in the network. Okay, we must keep the components on the computer network. Okay, here the major implication is the performance, reliability, and the security of the resulting system. Why? Because in the distributed distribution system, these are located at different places. So we must realize, we must have the performance, we must need reliability and security as well. This is the first one, the client server basic model. Client server basic model. Here, this color resembles the computer, and this resembles this ellipse represents the process. Here we have client process, client, this is these two are client and server processes. First, client, client invokes the server, and server will give the response to the client. All we know about it. Client processes interact with individual server processes. Individual server processes in a separate computer in order to access the data or resources. How they will communicate? By giving the invocation, the server will give the result. Best example is a web server is often a client of file server. See how we will communicate. Browser, next search engine, next one. Here the client server architecture is having two types. First one is classic model, that is two-tier model. Next one is three-tier model, when the server becomes a client. Next, multi-tier, this is called as a cascade model. See, in the two-tier model, this is a classic model, only client and server. Client will give invocation, server will give result. These two are communicate via internet. Three-tier model. In the three-tier model, who are present? Client. This is a client and as well as server. Here, how many parts? One is client, one is two servers and one client. The server sometimes acts as a client. Why? Because even the server needs some information from the client. So it will give request. See, the middle one, it will give request to the server and this. Even observed this point, what I told in the beginning of the class, this is a client, this is a client, this is a server. What is the difference? These two are peer-to-peer systems. This is not a server, but it will act as a server. Hope you understand. See, we have, this is a client, this is also a client, and this is a server. But the middle client, this one, this client will act as a server. Why? Because these two clients are peer-to-peer systems. These two peer-to-peer systems will come in with cooperation. This client will get data sometimes from this client. That is the reason why I mentioned here as server as client. That is the reason why when the server becomes a client. Next, cascade model. In the cascade model, we have multiple servers, clients, server client, etc., etc. Okay, three models we have. First one is two-tier model, that is classic model, only one client, one server. Next, three-tier model, in which we have one client, server becomes a client and a server. In the multi-tier, client, server becomes a client, etc. Next, how the general interaction between client and server. See, client will give a request to the server. This is the waiting time after giving the request and provide services. Server will provide services and give the reply. This is the time. This is the general interaction between any client and server. Upon receiving the request or invocation from the client, the server will give the reply. Okay, this is the waiting time between the request and reply. Okay. Next, a service provided by multiple servers. A service provided by multiple servers. See, in the diagram, we have two clients and servers. These three servers are connected. Here, clients are getting services. Clients are getting results, getting services from more than one server. More than one server. This client is getting from this server. This might also get from the server. This server, etc. Okay, that is what they mentioned here. The services may be implemented as several server processes in a separate host computers. Okay, all these three servers provides what they will provide. They will provide to different separate host computers. Okay, example is clustered based web servers and apps such as Google parallel databases, Oracle. Okay. In the tomorrow's class, we will discuss about proxy servers, and after that, we will discuss about peer process. Okay, how many processes we have? Client process, server process, peer process, proxy, peer process. Okay. Thank you, students. In tomorrow's class, same time I will join you. I'll join with you by 11:15 a.m. Okay. Thank you, students. Have a great day.